Phosphorus deficiency is a big problem for a lot of country in northern Australia. A lot of our soils are very low in phosphorus and it can have a big impact on cattle production. The main issue with phosphorus deficiency is cattle that are not adequate in phosphorus, they have a reduced appetite, and that means they eat less pasture, and that means that they have less energy and protein in their diet. Most producers are familiar with the clinical signs of a severe phosphorus deficiency. These include the classic things like chewing bones and other objects, but there are other symptoms like stiff gait when cattle walk, peg leg, and then even bone breakages. The more common issues with a phosphorus deficiency though are a big reduction in production.
Yeah, we're the MacArthurs. We live at Mystery Park, St. Lawrence. We run a breeding backgrounding enterprise. Land types vary. We go from blue gum creek flats, which I believe do have a fair bit of phosphorus in it, onto ironbark ridges and tea tree poplar gum sort of country, which is low in phosphorus. So yeah, prior to us supplementing, our preg test rates were down. Our breeder condition wasn't what it should have been, and like our weaners were smaller.
Recent work by the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries has shown that it's very profitable to supplement cattle with phosphorus, particularly in the wet season. The main reason that it's very profitable is because we reduce breeder mortalities, we increase the number of cull cow sales, and we also increase our weaning rates, which has an overall impact on the productivity of the property.
Since supplementing our herd with phosphorus, we've seen an increase in conception rates. Our breeders' condition has certainly improved, and our young cattle are certainly in a lot better state, like growing a lot better and a lot better condition.
There's a range of ways you can feed phosphorus to cattle. A broad grouping of them would be loose licks, as in they're generally products based on monocalcium phosphates or dicalcium phosphate or a blend of those two compounds. You can also buy high phosphorus blocks, which are weather resistant and are a potentially useful strategy where it's hard to access paddocks in the wet season. The other way it can be fed, of course, is in via water medication systems. Another potential way to feed a phosphorus supplement is mixing it up with molasses.
So we know our input costs, so we know how much the cropper meal is costing us per tonne, we know how much the DCP is costing, we know how many kilograms we're putting out in the paddock, and we know how many grams the cattle are eating per head, so it's just the mathematics that surround that. I guess now we've moved from second guessing whether we're phosphate deficient to actually being able to use our lot numbers, and then DAF help us identify our land types. The mapping's all there, so then our supplementing becomes really targeted and we know that this is actually what the cattle need.
The pea screen test is a blood test of the blood inorganic phosphorus levels, and it was developed about 20 years ago, and the idea is by undertaking the test, we can establish what the status of the animals is, whether they are acutely deficient or adequate for phosphorus, or maybe just classed as deficient. The kits are currently supplied by the Department of Agriculture and Fisheries laboratory at the Biological Sciences Precinct in Coopers Plains. Contact your local DAF extension officer and they can organise delivery of the kits for you. So what we're able to assess from the combination of the blood phosphorus levels and also the diet quality, be it fecal nitrogen level or NIRS, is whether the animals are acutely deficient or perhaps adequate for phosphorus. And once we know that, we can then make decisions about what we need to supplement and when we need to supplement.
And it's really important not to get into a situation where you are overgrazing or overstocking, because that will reduce your ground cover. And it's important to maintain good ground cover so that we capture all of our rainfall and don't get into a situation where we have runoff into waterways and creeks. There's a lot of staff and resources that are available to help producers with phosphorus. We have a lot of free tools that can be accessed on the Future Beef website, and there are beef extension staff all over Queensland that can help producers with this. So contact your local beef extension officer or call our DAF call centre.